47 we have to start, and last week in the 46th verse we saw yada pravrutti bhutanam yena sarvamidam tatam swakarmanantam abhyarchya siddhi vindati manavah. He from whom proceeds the activity of beings and by whom all this is pervaded, by worshipping him through his action, man attains perfection. If we remember in chapter 6 also, there it was told that better than doing meditation is to act in life. Always do karma. But do the karma in the right manner, the result of which is purification, and that purification then pulls you in. When you come to meditation in this manner, then there is no coming back again. Then the resolution is complete. But people in today's time, they want meditation without taking care of their actions. They are doing all sorts of things, but they are doing meditation. It's not going to give us fruit. And the second way is that by worshipping him through his actions, rather than perform, I am performing, I am speaking, I am doing, I am the actor doing the activity. Instead of this, be engaged in whatever life is presenting you, and if at all there is a sense of doership, because when we say karma, there is doership. How do you do the karma? Without expecting any results and doing it for the Lord. The attitude that this karma is happening by His will, or one lower, that I am doing this for the Lord. In this way, when our attention is on liberation, then our attention will not be on the karma. Our attention will be, who is that because of whom activity is ensuing forth, you know. So in that manner, now we come to the 47th verse. 47th verse says, Treyan swadharmo Shreyan swadharmo vigunaha, Shreyan swadharmo vigunaha, paradharmat svanushthitat, swabhavaniyatam karma, kurvannapnoti kilbisham. Together, Shreyan swadharmo vigunaha, paradharmat svanushthitat, swabhavaniyatam karma, kurvannapnoti kilbisham. Better is one's own duty though defective than another's duty well performed. In doing work as dictated by one's own nature, one does not incur sin. See, this is a big one in today's time. You want promotion, you want to do someone else's job, and you want to do it better so that you get the promotion, and the other fellow feels that he is nothing in front of your performance. And same thing, wherever in a society the people are living for individual rights, there, what has government done for us? I will do what I feel in that manner. Or in that society where there should be freedom, but that true freedom is from the knowing the self. But when this manipulated, distorted freedom is experienced, that like the various rights group, environmentalist group, I'm not saying it is wrong, but when it starts, how should I say, I'm not blaming the groups, but what I'm looking at is the attitude behind those people who are standing up for those causes. Are you ready to sacrifice everything for that cause? Are you a natural? Some people are natural chefs. Some people are natural carpenters. Some people are natural weavers. A woman, many women I see, after childbirth, they are natural mothers. But I have seen those also who don't want the child. And they keep complaining. See? So what is, then it was better you stay single. So what is our natural disposition? When it comes that way, that time a mother doesn't think, a sculptor doesn't think that what am I going to get in return. He enjoys the making the sculpture. A painter enjoys making the painting, immaterial of whether someone gives him money or doesn't give him money. He is not doing it for business purpose. It is because it is his passion. Same way, one must get involved in activity. And we told you how to determine where your activity is by assessing yourself rather than copy someone else. And here Gyaneshwar Maharaj begins his talk. Aga apulaha swadharmu acharani zari vishamu tari pahavato parinamu phale lalen zene jay sukha lagi apanapaya nimbachi athi dhananjaya tay kadu vatapana tayachiya उभगी जेना फळनया हैली कडे केळिते पाहाता आसमोडे ऐसी त्यजिली तरी जोडे तैसे के गोमटे. Even though one's own duty is difficult to perform, one should keep in view its ultimate result. If one feels better by eating the seeds of the neem tree, one should not mind its bitterness. Would it be wise to cut down the banana tree before it has borne fruit? And sometimes we see, even in among sannyasis, we see many students who came. They came as an escape from the responsibilities at home, thinking sannyas, free food, free accommodation, 2 years of clothes, toothpaste, toothbrush, soap. But they didn't realize it was going to be 6-7 lectures every day, and they had to attend every one of them. And then on top of that, there is so much of Narayan Seva that has to be done. Oh, with such people, within few months they were culled out of the system. Why they came there? Because it was not natural for them. It was an escape from their responsibility. They thought that, oh, sannyas, it's a noble thing to do, and we'll go and join the ashram and we'll study. But that disposition was not there. It was an imagination in their head. Without having the qualification, they were wanting to go there because they don't want to do where life has placed them. See, their next door opens only when we have performed 100 to our best the job where life has placed us. Then the next door opens. And do it joyfully. If you do it cringing, that will continue. It will keep persecuting you. And here, as Gyaneshwar Maharaj says, even if it is hard wherever life has placed you, continue with it. What other? That is your duty. You do it. If one feels better by eating the seeds of the neem tree, one should not mind its bitterness. Same way in the house, we are going to work, the bosses are not good, the environment is not good, you keep working. At home, everyone is going to work, you are at home, you have to keep doing everything. You get exhausted, sometimes certainly the thoughts will come that why everything is on me. But we keep plodding because that is where life has placed us. And try to not find joy in the work, but do the work joyfully. Problem comes when we try to find the joy. then he explains. So even if there are, just as a beautiful rose comes with the thorns, same way, our wherever life has placed us, not necessarily that everything is wonderful, beautiful, fantastic. No, there are thorns. Some people are not getting along with you. Other people take you for granted. Different attitudes. So we do not worry about it. We keep doing what we are required to do where life has placed us. Continuing in the 926, Devi Swadharmu Sangadu Dekho Viravi Dekho Ni Kela Zari Kadu Tari Moksha Suravadu Antaral Antaralapki Ani Apuli Maye Kubza Zari Ahe तरी जिये ते नोहे स्नेह कुरहे की ये रीजिया बराविया रंबे हुनी भरविया तिया काय कराविया बाढ़के तेने अगा पानिया हुनी बहुए तू तुपी गुण की रहे परी मीना काय होए असने ते थ पै आघविया जगाजे विख ते विष ते विख किडियाचे पियूख आणि जगा गुळ ते देख मरण तया. He said, Jnaneshwar Maharaj says, in the same way, if a person were to give up his duty on the ground that it is hard to perform, he would be deprived of the bliss of liberation. Even if it is hard, we must continue to perform our duty, because if we run away from what we are supposed to perform in life, there will be regrets later on, somewhere. On the seat of meditation, that regret will come. Imagine you are sitting in meditation, don't disturb, I am doing meditation. And what is the time? At the time of breakfast. Everyone is screaming, hey, where is my breakfast? And you are doing meditation. Kya? Ek baar sun loge, do baar sun loge, baad mein. What is this? Same thing at job. If a person were to give up his duty on the ground that it is hard to perform, he would be deprived of the bliss of liberation. Liberation is not there is no lag. If we are at one with the act that is being performed, meaning the performer and the performed are one, there you are, everything is over. The doer vanishes, the work vanishes, only the self remains there. He would be deprived of the bliss of liberation. If a child's mother is ugly, the motherly love on which it is sustained is not ungainly. The mothers of other children may be more beautiful than the nymph Ramba, but of what avail are they to the child? No child says, I want Hema Malini as mother. Everyone calls their mother however she is. Whether she is deformed, whether she is beautiful, whether she is ugly, whether she is in whatever, he or she loves the mother in spite of. We don't compare our mother to anyone else. Then why do we compare our duty with someone else's? Question is this. Don't compare. But of what avail are they to the child? O Arjuna, the ghee has better qualities than water, but can the fish live in it? Nice example. Ghee is better than water because it cleanses you, it lubricates you, but the fish cannot live in water. Other person's work may be good, may be beneficial, but it is not for you. Your place of duty, your place of work is where life has placed us. But can and the fish live in it. Look, what is poison to the world is like nectar to the germs, and what is jaggery to the world proves fatal to the germs. We in India, not here. Nowadays here also, because nowadays the green bin is with all food stuff, isn't it? So we throw the food, yuck, it is filth, and all the worms, cockroaches, flies, for them it is heaven. We in India, we throw the food, and for the pig or swine, for them it is heaven. See? So what is poison to the world is like nectar to the germs. What is jaggery to the world proves fatal to the germs. So with these examples is we continue further. 9:31. मनोनि जे विहित जया जेने फिटे संसाराचे धरणे क्रिया कठोर तरहि तेणे तेचि करावी ये रा पराचारावर बरविया ऐसे होई लटेंकलिया टेंकलया पायाचे चालणे डोइया केले जैसे या लागी कर्म आपुले जे जाति स्वभावे असे आले ते करी तेने जिंतिले कर्म बंधाते आणि स्वधर्मुची पाळावा परधर्मु तो गाळावा हे हाने मोही पांडवा न कीजेची पैगा तरी आत्मा दुष्ट नो हे तव कर्म करणे काठाये आणि करणे ते थाहे आयासु आधी. He says that for this reason a person should perform the prescribed duties by which alone he can hope to attain liberation, though it may be difficult to accomplish if he were to perform another's duty thinking it to be better than his own. It is like walking on his head instead of his legs. Therefore, if one performs one's duty which has fallen to his lot according to his birth, he alone trumps over the bonds of action. Then why should one not make it a rule that one will observe only one's own dharma and not follow another's duty? So here Gyaneshwar Maharaj is saying, you make a deep, firm resolve within yourself that where, in what family you are born, with what qualities you are born, and where life has placed you, and what duties have fallen upon you, you follow your path. You follow your path. Don't look around. Because that's the way to moksha. Even though it is difficult, if he were to perform another's duty thinking it to be better than his own, it's like walking on his head instead of legs. So we sweat, we work hard. For what? Only to be troubled in our mind, only to be irritated, to have more desires after that. That if, where will it end? Today I want to do what you are doing. Once I have accomplished what you, I become better than you. Then I want to I want to do what the next one is. And we keep doing that. And in the end, who is frustrated? Not others. We are frustrated. Therefore, if one performs one's duty which has fallen to his lot according to his birth, he alone trumps over the bonds of action. See? And when we try to do other person's actions, then we are creating more data to process. When we are following our dharma, where life has placed us, what is the prescribed actions? What are the prescribed action? Whatever the scripture sanction. If you don't know what scripture sanction, too many scriptures, whatever Mahatmas tell you to do, you do that. See? when Swamiji used to come, early years, every time he used to come, before going, he will tell somewhere in the trip, he'll say, you start Vishnu Sahasrara now. If he has said it, I used to do it. Next time he said, now you do Parayana of Panchadashi. I used to do that. And he never said, you must do it. Never. It was just a suggestion. But you have to be open that some discussion is going on, and if he is suggesting that if you do this, it will help, you take it on and run. Because we don't know what is a teacher, a Guru Maharaj knows us better than we do ourselves, isn't it? Or those who are very, very obstinate that I have to do it, and they are Shastris and they are Pujaris and they are day in and day out, they are doing the pujas, then that's okay, because they are following what the scripture, they do the Agnihotra every day, they study the Bhagavad Gita every day, they do their pranayama every day, yoga every day, they are doing their meditation, dhyan every day, but they must do it joyfully. Then why should, it comes over the bonds of action. Then why should one not make it a rule that one will observe only one's own dharma and not follow another's duty? So now, understand, one must follow one's own dharma. Then how come those of you who read Papa Ramdas's life, In Quest of God, I sent some of you this book. If not, ask me and I'll send it to you. Or ISKCON, you know, Prabhupada, he was also married. He was also having a wife and child. Papa Ramdas was married. He was having a wife and child. Oh, they left the house. They did not do what their life was had placed them to do. Oh, now, how do you resolve this? How do you resolve this? Did they escape from the responsibilities of wife and children and father and mother? What happened there? Immediately we bring these type of examples and don't allow what Bhagavad Gita, what Krishna Bhagavan is telling to Arjuna to sink in. Because they followed their own dharma wherever life has placed, therefore they left. They became paripakva, they became matured in their devotion to the Lord. And it was an unshakable pull, an uncontrollable pull, which took them away from the family. And within a few years, they become realized. Nisargadatta Maharaj, 2 years with the family, in the house, in one room. Gundavlekar Maharaj, Gora Kumbhar, Jnaneshwar Maharaj, with his 4 brothers, 3 brothers and sister. He never left them. Yet realized. So what happened there? Some of them left, some of them didn't. But what happened there? They did not complain about the circumstances that life had placed them. And even if they complain, yes, we do complain when life is difficult. But they continued to perform joyfully. Few moments here, there do come, but overall, if you look at the picture, all of them, they continued to perform joyfully, remembering the name of the Lord, doing the japa. Kabirdasji kept weaving, Gora Kumbhar kept making the pots. Okay? See, ये बड़ी बहुत बड़ी बात है ये. Don't compare yourself to another family. And this is a big mistake that we do with our children. We compare our children with other people's children. Are they are unique. They are your product. Accept them as they are and see their confidence grow, because they see that the parents trust us, the parents have confidence in us, the parents have never compared us to anyone else. See, that person got took those subjects, why can't you take their subject? those people got so much marks, why didn't you get so many marks? Then you are what? Unknowingly, you are sapping them of all enthusiasm towards life. See? Let them unfold, let them grow, they will make their mistakes, they will correct their mistakes, and they will, wherever, whatever path is charted out for them, give them confidence to follow that. Give them confidence to follow these principles, that wherever life has placed you, you follow that, don't run away. That is why divorces happen. That is why court cases happen between brother and brother, children suing their parents, parents suing their children, partners suing each other. Why? This is the reason, because we are not doing what we are supposed to do, where life has kept us joyfully. Then why should one not make it a rule that one will observe only one's own dharma, swadharma? This dharma is not for atma. This dharma is for the personality. Who is that? This soul, this individual who is here. Atma is not giving lecture. Swami Paramananda is giving lecture. Who is Swami Paramananda? Yes, the name may mean infinite bliss, but you know Swami Paramananda as this body with this particular features. See? And he has got a certain personality with certain qualities, some shortcomings, good and bad is in everyone. So all that put together, this is this fellow. See? So what is our swadharma? Do you discover your swadharma by going to school? No. Do you discover your swadharma by running away from home? No. You discover swadharma by accepting where life has placed you at this moment. So what is your swadharma at this moment? To listen, to talk. Do it joyfully, listen joyfully. Story over. Yes, many things will be difficult. Some things you may not understand, some things you will understand. Some things I may not be able to express explicitly, some things I will be able to express explicitly. But we keep prodding, we keep improving, we keep working for greater and greater perfection. This is what I do when I wash dishes. I have to wash the same cup every day after tea or my plate. It's full awareness, and with minimum expenditure of energy, how can I get 110% result? Every time my attention is on that only. So let that type of disposition be in everything, how you speak, how you walk, how you wear, how you conduct yourself, what abilities are there, keep enhancing them, keep, I get distracted from what I'm supposed to do, keep becoming alert about it, day in and day out, every moment, make that commitment. Can one really stop work before one has not had the vision of self? Who is seeking the self? Who is seeking the self? The individual. Huh? You can say the individual is seeking the self, the mind is seeking the self. Can the mind be without activity? As long as seeking is there, seeking is also an activity, thinking is also an activity, contemplation is also an activity. So whether you are thinking or you are acting at the body level outwards, activity is continued as long as you are an individual considering yourself to be this body, mind, intellect. Till then you cannot escape from activity. You cannot escape from activity. still continue, but there will be no doer of activity. As long as there is individuality, there is a doer of activity. I am contemplating, I am meditating, I am listening, I am seeing, hearing, touching, feeling, tasting, I am thinking, I am contemplating, reflecting, listening. So everywhere I am, this I am is the doer. And that's what Jnaneshwar Maharaj is saying, that can one really stop work before one has not had the vision of the self? No, you cannot stop. Life will continue. You may stop physically, but mentally it is still going on. You may stop mentally when you go to sleep. Internally the functions are still going on. Blood is flowing, breath is moving. So there is no eternal stop to it, because nature is also eternal relatively. Can one really stop work before one has not had the vision of the self? And if there is action to be performed, it is bound to entail physical labor. See, where there is subtle activity and there is physical activity. Physical activity is that what I am doing right now, speaking, is physical activity. What you are doing, if you are contemplating, reflecting on what the words are coming to you, that is subtle activity. That is not physical activity. And subtle activity is always, it requires more energy. The expenditure of energy is more in thinking than in physical. You understand? So, and if there is action to be performed, if you just take it at the gross level, if action has to be performed, it will entail physical labor. If I have to give a lecture, that is my duty, 7:30 Thursday evening, give lecture on Bhagavad Gita, it will require me to open the mouth. It will require my vocal cords to be exercised. And you do, if you give 2, 3, 4 lectures in a day, then you do get exhausted. Continuing in the 48th verse, he says, Sahajam karma kaunteya, sahajam karma kaunteya, sadosham abhinatyajet, sadosham abhinatyajet, sarvarambahi dhoshena, सर्वारंभा ही दोषेना धूमेनाग्निर्या क्या है धूमेनाग्निरिवावृताः टुगेदर सहजं कर्म कौन्तेय सदोषमपि न त्यजे सर्वारंभा ही दोषेना धूमेना अग्निरिवावृताः This is also very, very important point, what is coming next. He says, one should never abandon one's duty. That is the first part. Sahajam karma kaunteya, sadosham api na tyaje. Even if there is a fault in it, you must continue. Don't discard it. You continue to perfect it. How? Naturally. The natural duties that have come to your lot, come to you unasked, we must perform, even if they are difficult, even if they are having a fault. Like someone, you know, when someone dies at the border, some officer, some commandant, some military personnel has to go to the deceased family's house and tell the wife, the children, or the parents the sad news of the demise of their father or the son or the husband. How bad it is. How much heartache is there. But it is a duty. Even though it is hard, still the boss has ordered, you have to go and give the message. He has to go and give the message in the best possible way, that they feel proud of the person who has passed away. He can controls his emotions, he shows as much as is required. One should not abandon one's duty, O son of Kunti, even though it may be faulty. So when he says here, sadosham api na tyajet, even if it has a fault, even if it has a shortcoming, it should not be given up. I am not a good speaker. There are many better than me. But we continue. Someone will benefit. Someone will. Our mind is first listening. You are giving satsang to yourself. You are talking to yourself. Or are we talking to someone else? Think. So we must. There is no action. Remember one thing. There is no action which is perfect. Every action will have some fault in it. Because someone will see good in it, someone will see bad in it. It is a foregone conclusion. No, the whole society, the whole earth will never say this action is 100% good. Krishna, the Purushottama, when he performed, Gandhari blamed him, Gandhari cursed him. So many others misunderstood him. See? But it is that Krishna who said that if I have never been attached to either Kauravas or Pandavas, let Parikshit come back to life. Who can say that? Who has lived life alertly, vigilantly, never fallen from that extreme awareness, who has continuously performed. People say, oh, he is a war, he created the war to happen, he incited the Pandavas, he purposely did not accept the dinner offered by Duryodhana. Why should he accept? When he is saying it so arrogantly, whereas Vidur and his wife, whatever their little was there, they offered him, and he went and he took, because he is the king, because he is the self-proclaimed Rajkumar prince, therefore he is ordering Krishna, you have to come to my house. Who are you to call me man? Do we have that type of courage to stand? He is doing his duty, he is following his Swadharma. And what is his Swadharma? Remain equanimous, no sides. But because he is not taking sides, does not mean that anyone can walk over him. Eh? No. He has got a sharp intellect. If he sees the bhava of the person who is inviting, why should we go if someone is arrogantly calling? For all actions are overlaid by defects as fire is with smoke. So there is no action which is pure. Activity requires what? What is the basis of activity? Where does activity happen? Yeah, in the mind. Okay, in the mind. He says in the mind. What is mind? Where there is?
Ahamanditam.
Huh?
Ahamanditam.
Aham and
duality.
Idam. Mind is that where there is duality. There is karta and karma. There is I and that. There is a doer and done. There is a seer and seen. This is what mind is. See? And where there is duality, there can never be perfection. Simple rule. Yes. At a ground level, it seems that there is no perfection, but in duality, when we look at totality, it seems perfect compared to individuality. Totality seems to be perfect compared compared to individuality. But when we bypass and go to the source, we find individuality and duality, totality, both are superimpositions, both are imaginations, both are existing in their own absence, both are coming and going. Just like we are coming and going, our lifespan may be 60, 70, 80, 90 years. Brahmaji's lifespan is longer, that's all. They also become unmanifest and they also become manifest. Not just Brahmaji, all of them. See, when they unmanifest, what happens? They go back to Narayana. They go back to the source, the Paramatma, Parabrahma, Paramatma. That's not the topic here, but understand this, that no activity can be ever pure because it has been corrupted by duality. So how do you make action which is happening in duality to be the doorway to liberation? By offering it to the Lord. What will happen when you offer it to the Lord? Your attention goes to the Lord rather than the action. And Lord is of the nature of perfection compared to individual. So action automatically happens perfectly. See? Or the other way, at a very ground level, that the doer and the done, the karta and the karma, they become one. When you are at one with the, so if I'm at one meant with the speech that is coming forth, the ego does not come in. I continuously in that sense of awareness, sense of equanimity, and allowing whatever comes out and it flows through. Some moments are there, not all the time. And that moment, the work has, the action has become a doorway to the reality. Because you are in that. Today when we are chanting, after that chanting, as Aarti was saying, that it was, I could have sat down and for a long time. What happened there? What was chanting? What is japa? Action. You are performing, you are deciding, you have traveled, you have opened the book, you are reading, you are chanting. After one and a half hour of chanting, everything in your mind, the urge to act has itself got dissolved. It has got dissolved. Yes, in a group it's easier. We have to learn how to do it on our own. And you do it not in mentally, you do it physically. Loud chanting, Vaikhari. Then it will take you, it will pull you into Madhyama, naturally, without you even knowing. Then it will go into Pashyanti and Para. This is the techniques. Then, now what is happening? That karma of doing japa, the karma of chanting, is taking you to the doorway of the self, doorway of moksha. So wonderful. Continuing, our Maneshwar Maharaj says, Marna, kya time hai? Manauni bhalatiye karmi आयासु जरहि उपक्रमी तरीकायस्वधर्मी दोषु सांगे आगा उजु वाटा चालावे तरहि पाय चेषणवावे ना आडराने धावावे तरहि तेची पैशिडा का सिदोरिया दाटने एक धनंजया परिजे वाहता विसावया मिलिजेते ढेपे यर्वी कणा आणी भूसा कांडिता ही सोसु सरिसा जे चिरंधन श्वान मासा ते ची हवी दधी जड़ा चिया घुसड़ना व्यापार सारी खेची विचक्षणा वाड़ुवे तिड़ा घाणा गाड़ने एक. This is, since every action involves labor in the beginning, then why should one find fault with one's duty on the ground that is laborious? O Arjuna, one becomes equally fatigued even if one walks on a highway or a bypath. Whether one carries a stone or provision for the journey, the burden is the same. Very simple. This is still a rumal. It has maybe 100-200 grams. Even if you take a piece of paper from this book and you hold it, after some time you will start sweating, man. Your hand will start hurting. That light paper, yes, maybe with this book, it will take 5 minutes for me to get tired. Maybe with the paper, it will take maybe a little bit longer. But I will feel the heaviness of that piece of paper. Eventually, I will sweat, I will get tired, I will get exhausted. Whether one carries a stone or provision for the journey, the burden is the same. Therefore, one should carry the burden which will relieve fatigue caused by the journey at the rest house. So, what is the burden we should carry? The burden of our swadharma, rather than someone else's dharma. Because if it is someone else's, we will never get rid of it. If we are doing the swadharma, we will get rid of it. It will dissolve. It will purify. Pounding corn or chaff involves the same labor. So does cooking meat and cooking food for sacrificial purposes. O intelligent Arjuna, one has to toil equally in churning curd and water or in crushing sand and sesame in an oil mill. He is giving these examples here that whether you do someone else, compare yourself with someone and then try to do what the other is doing, or you do where life has placed you. You have to go through the chakki. Chakki means mill. You have to go to the grinding mill. Life is the grinding mill. And you have to go through the responsibilities, the duties, breakfast, lunch, dinner, lecture, cleaning, chanting, driving, chauffeuring, eating, cooking. All this requires energy. It exhausts you in the end. So it's better to follow your swadharma because it will purify you. Continuing in the 41st. Painitya Homa Deyavaya Kasaira Agi Suvavaya Punkita Dhujanan Dhananjaya Sahane Techi Pari Dharma Patni Dhangadi Posita Zari Eki Vodhi Tarika Aparavadi आनावी आगा आगा पाठी लागला भाई मरण न चुके ची पाही तरी समोरला काही आगण आगडले न कीजे कुलस्त्री दाढ्याचे खाए परघर रिगाली ही जरी साहे तरी स्वपती ते वाहे सांडिले की तैसे आवडते ही करणे न निपजेश शिनल शिनल्याविने तरी विहित बारे कोणे बोले भारी. He said, Jnaneshwar Maharaj is saying that one has to suffer from smoke. Here he took the example that fire comes along with the smoke, and what you want, agni, homa, the smoke will be there for some time. And what does smoke do? You want the fire to do your offerings, ahutis, but what does the smoke do? It gives you the itchy eyes. The fire comes with heat, you are sweating, you are burning, but you have to do the complete the performance of the homa. So both ways you can take. One has to suffer from smoke. If one kindles fire for an obligatory sacrifice or for other work, one has to incur expenditure equally in supporting a wife or a kept woman. Why then incur the odium of a scandal by keeping a mistress? if you have to put extra work, you have to perform actions in order to take care of your wife or a mistress, then why he's saying, why keep a mistress? You put that extra work taking care of your wife and children only. If one cannot avoid death by turning one's back to the enemy, then why should one not face the enemy and fight with him? This is our Galwan Valley. How they faced 20 Indian soldiers face to face. Very easy to show your back. If you are going to get shot with your back towards the enemy, why get that disgrace? Why not face the enemy and take the shot in your chest? And that's from that way we are here. Nanishwar Maharaj is saying, why not face the responsibility? Why you shirk away from the responsibilities? Because they will not stop pursuing you. The responsibilities, duties will not stop pursuing us. So better face them rather than run away from them, rather than shirk them. If one cannot avoid death by turning one's back to the enemy, then why should one not face the enemy and fight with him? If a lady from a good family has to bear the blows of a stick in another's house, does it not mean that she has made a mistake in leaving her husband because he beat her? It is on those. Here also, domestic violence is so much. What happens in domestic violence? Someone is. You cannot. Problem does not happen only from one side. It is both ways. Taali to do tarah se basti hai na. But you decide. You decide. Like one person is there. She got married, got used, produced a child, then divorced. Why? He used me. Then it dawned her. Because he said, my studies are over, thank you for taking care of me and paying myself and giving me accommodation. And she had a baby with that person. Then he went and left. But this person, depressed. Then came out of depression. How to get out of depression? Drink. In the pub, meet another person. Again get married. That again, second marriage also, same thing. Again he was studying. He used that person. Again another kid. Again he left. See? Why you have to leave anywhere? Why you want to change a place? Why you want to change a... Nyaneshwar Maharaj's parents didn't leave. They were thrown out of the village. They continued staying there. They faced the persecution of the society. See? Hamara kya hai? Neither we are fighting 100% nor we are surrendering 100%. We are in the middle like the ghost. That is our problem. If a lady from a good family has to bear the blows of a stick in another's house, does it not, and why did she leave the house in the first place? Because the husband beats me. Domestic violence. So she went into divorce, got married, went into someone else's house. Now what? There also the same thing is happening. You should have stayed with the first one and found a resolution. Where we are going wrong? How can it be resolved? How can it be corrected? You have got some counseling. Does it not mean that she has made a mistake in leaving her husband's house? He bet her. If therefore we cannot avoid physical labor in performing any action, even of our liking, then how can we complain that the prescribed action is difficult to perform? Important point. Then, therefore, we cannot avoid are sitting and listening to lecture, you will get tired after some time. I am speaking, I will get tired after some time. I am driving, I will get tired after some time. Car is driving, but I am pressing, I am holding the steering wheel. Still I will get tired. If I am sleeping, I will get tired of sleeping. I want to get up. वहां पे भी शांति नहीं है. He said, we cannot avoid physical labor in performing any action, even if it is of our liking. Then how can we complain that the prescribed action is difficult to perform? So what is to be done? Wherever there is prescribed action, that means where whatever we are meant to perform in a given situation in our life, where life has placed us, do it joyfully. Do it as an offering to the Lord. Do it with equanimity. Do it with inspiration. See, इसके लिए एक तरीका है. इधर अभी बताया नहीं है. अंतर लक्ष्य बहिर्दृष्टि. Where is action happening? At the equipment level. Where is your attention? Is your attention on the work or is your attention on the antar lakshya means attention on who is watching that the action is taking place. See. फिर देखो मजा. So do not complain that prescribed action is difficult. Like when we were young, we went and got the हमारा जनेऊ कर दिया था, the third ceremony. After that, every day we had to light the lamp, and after lighting the lamp, 21 times we had to chant Gayatri Mantra. Oh my God, I tell you, those 5-7 minutes used to be like, for in those 21 minutes, how many times we'll doze off? There was no interest. It's prescribed. Parents didn't force us, that's a different matter. But at that time, oh man, it was a big punishment. Getting the jaleo was exciting, but getting the haircut was disgusting. That I am a brahmachari now, that accolade was good, but to perform what is involved with brahmacharya as a one who is holding, having the janeu, all those actions we don't want to perform. Why? Lazy. Because, so that time we were complaining, this is too long, can't there be a smaller one? If I knew what I know now, then I would have done the smaller om 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 21 khatam kar deta. But om bhur bhuva swaha tat savitur varena, long one. You could do your om also and finish. But we didn't, because our parents didn't know.
वरी थोड़े ची अमृत घेता सर्वस्व वेचो का पंडुसुता जेने जोड़े जीविता अक्षयत्व ये रकाहिया बोले वेंचुनी विषपिया वे खेवनी आत्महत्ये सी निमोनी जाई जे जेने तैसे जाचुनिया इंद्रिये वेंचुनी आयुष्याचे निदिये सांजले पापी आन आहे दुखावाचुनी मनावनी करावा स्वधर्मु जो करिता हेरोनी घेश्रमु उचित देईल परमु पुरुषार्थ राजु या कारणे किरीटी स्वधर्माची ये राहाटी न विसंबिजे संकटी सिद्ध मंत्र जैसा. Why not spend all we have to get a little quantity of nectar that makes life immortal? Huh? Why not spend all we have to get a little quantity of nectar that makes life immortal. Why should one buy poison, drink it and die, and also incur the sin of committing suicide? When do you commit suicide? When do you commit suicide? When you do not perform your prescribed duties, your swadharma, joyfully with inspiration. When do you commit suicide? When you copy someone else's karma and try to perform that. That is committing suicide. When we are not offering the karma at the feet of the Lord, then we are committing suicide. Three places. Why? He will tell you now. In the same way, if a person accumulates sin by slogging his senses and wasting his life, what does he gain except misery? See, I'm going, one girl is coming to me, last two, three times she has come, and we are going for a walk in Jel's Park. Grown up, 25, 26 years old, knows she's been attending youth classes and all that. All the data is there. But somewhere in these 2 years of lockdown, she has programmed herself that I am in a cage, I need to break free, and now once the cage has opened, socializing this, that, and her mind is going like a horse is running hither and thither. Every sense is going everywhere. She wants to do so many things. And as a result, what happens? When all horses run everywhere, the chariot does not move forward, isn't it? You need a strong intellect to keep the horses in check. They only go where we want it to go. She knows all this. Yet, somewhere she lost the plot. And now I am just being a sounding board. And she asks something, I tell her the principles. And suddenly, yesterday, she said, "Oh, Swamiji, I know all this." I said, "Good, if you know it." And then she started telling what she knows. And she said, "Yeah, now I realized that I went away from myself. I was living at the senses level. I should live at the self level. Why did I go there?" I said, "Don't ask that question. It happened." Question is, important point is that at this moment when you are recognizing it, are you recognizing it deep enough to transform your interaction, to bring about a transforming change in yourself, or is it only superficial? She says, "I don't know." I said, "Okay, time will tell. Otherwise, another talk, another walk." But that realization came to her just by talking to me, talking to someone. If it was not me, someone else. But other person would not have given the correct feedback if they didn't know. That's all. So same way, when we remain equanimous, here what he's saying is, where are we? Where? 46, na? Why not?
47.
Why not spend all we have to get a little quantity of nectar that makes life immortal? Why should one buy poison, drink it and die, and also incur the sin of committing suicide? So this girl has lost the plot, is a very successful person, for temporarily felt that the mind was going haywire, she was losing control. I'm adding those words just to make the story interesting, so that, and that's exactly what happens to us also, that senses are not in our control, we are dependent on the objects of the world, experiences of the world, environment, socializing, restauranting, drinking, movies, go for a walk here, go for a trip there, and we feel that we are living life now. We think we are living life, that I am, this is who I am. And yet, when she was talking to me, she realized that all this is unnecessary. She said to me that, "Swamiji, when I chose the subject whatever it was, physiotherapy or something, that when I chose that subject to study at uni, when I decided that I'm going to do physiotherapy, I made this decision that I'm doing physiotherapy because I feel a pull towards it. But I'm not doing physiotherapy because it will bring me money. It will bring me fame. I want to open a business. Nothing like that. If it was some other profession, I would have gone for that. But this was the calling. So I felt at one with this profession, so I took it. And I did well. But where did I lose it suddenly? How come I was determining my happiness based on outside stimuli? She is making this conclusion herself. This is exactly what Jnaneshwar Maharaj is telling us. Because she just changed one job to another job. Why did she change the... She is telling me, she changed the job, why? Because there was politics, there were backbiting, there was this, there was that. I said, wherever you go, it will be like that. She says, yes, I took in the new job, I organized the Kris Kringle, and I decided when I started the job that no matter what, I'm not going to be disturbed by anyone, whatever anyone says, I'm going to be self-inspired in my job. And I kept quiet. She also kept quiet. I stopped. She also stopped. I said, then, I'm not saying what she should say. She said, I could have done the same thing in my old job also. I could have been self-inspired rather than saying that these people are like that, job is like that, it's a government job, it is this, it is that. I could have had a positive outlook. Why did I suffer like that for 2 years? Her conclusion. So I said, so now, are you going to leave this job after some time? Again, make everyone look bad and you are the good one and now you have to look for another job? She says, no. If it comes, it will be a different reason, but not mistake which I have already done. Now I realize this. See? Bacche, 25-year-old, is giving me this knowledge. In the same way, if a person accumulates sin by slogging his senses and wasting his life, what does he gain except misery? If we are enjoying the video games day in and day out, what will we get? Bad eyes. If we are continuously listening to music, putting earbuds in the ear, what will we get? We'll become deaf. If we live a life of desire orientation, our senses and mind will become weak over the years. If we live an extroverted life, slogging his senses and wasting his life, what does he gain except misery? It is therefore meet that one should perform one's duty, which removes fatigue and helps one to attain liberation. So, perform where life has placed you. Again, Jnaneshwar Maharaj is coming to the center. Wherever life has placed you, perform with inspiration. But how do you do it? Perform with inspiration, but with dispassion. That's the art. Perform with 110% motivation or inspiration, but with a sense of dispassion. Expecting no results, and offering that action to the Lord. That is the art of action, performing action. And mind does not know, another point I will make here, mind does not know the difference between real and imaginary. If mind is programmed again and again, hey, I am here, I have to do my job, I might as well do it with inspiration and joy. And you keep, first time it will, you are forcing it. I am joyful. You do it few times, you'll start enjoying it. Whatever you are doing, you'll start enjoying it. If you say, goes on and on and on in your mind, and that becomes a cause for you to leave the job. Hasn't it happened to all of us sometime or the other? It is therefore meet that one should perform one's duty, which removes fatigue and helps one to attain liberation, because there are no regrets. There is fulfillment that we did what was required to be done to the best of our ability, without ego, of without expecting anything in return for our actions. Why? Because our attitude is, all is His will. Story over. जैसे राखी रखे राम तही विधि रही है, सीताराम 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 कही है। ये क्लिक हो जाना चाहिए जीवन में। रिमूव्स फैटीग एंड हेल्प्स वन टू अटेन लिबरेशन विच इज द हाईएस्ट एंड ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ। द पर्पस ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ इज to attain liberation, and this is how through action we can come to that. O Arjuna, just as one should not forget the tested formula, Siddha Mantra, in a difficult situation, so one should not give up one's duty at any time. With this Siddha Mantra, something comes to my mind. When we went to Kailash, one doctor was there, a surgeon. Off Harbor, we stay at his place, and he was 70, and we had to do some Tigram Bhaji to get him into the group. So we went to Kailash, and he got, you know, 71 year old, shorter than me, thin, and camera and lenses and phone and charger. There's so many paraphernalia he was carrying in his bag, and that bag was heavier than him. So Sherpa has to carry it. But every night, wherever we stay, that bag has to be with him. And when we are sleeping at night, we have to charge our phones, we have to charge our camera battery. And he was doing the same. And one morning he got up in one particular place, and he looked everywhere and he could not find his phone charger or the colored lens of his cameras. He could not find it anywhere. Itna bada piece hota hai, but he could not find it. And we put the doona up and down, we looked under the bed, everywhere, under the pillow. I was sleeping next to him. I checked mine also, nowhere. He said, Swamiji, you don't worry. You have to organize everyone. You go and do get everyone to organize for breakfast. I will do my thing. I'll find it. It will come to me. And what he does, whenever he is in trouble, anywhere, in an operation, on the traffic, parking, finding a parking place, wherever life, whenever he feels there is a challenge coming which he cannot handle, and he's getting irritated, he starts chanting Shri Guru Charan Saroj Raj Nij Man Mukur Sudhari Bharanam Raghubar Bimal Jasu Jodayak Phalachari Buddhihina Tanu Janike Sumirau Pavan Kumar Bhara Buddhi Vidya Dehu Mohi Arahu Kalesa Vikar. This is just the beginning mantra, and then the whole Hanuman Chalisa. And he has such a deep faith in Hanumanji that by the time Hanuman Chalisa ends, and he chants loudly, by the time Hanuman Chalisa ends, whatever he is looking for the solution, it gets resolved. 10 minutes later, he was out with the lens. And this didn't happen once. It happened 2-3 times. Not with length, maybe some other things. Siddha Mantra. Tum kya bolte ho? Agar kahi problem ho gaya. Once I went to Gangotri, and from Gangotri I climbed the glacier to go to Tapovan, and one brahmacharini was there with me.
She said, "Swamiji, no, nobody wanted to take me. I want to come." I said, "You are on your own. I am not taking anyone. I am not bringing back anyone. I don't want anyone's responsibility. The Sherpa is there, the guide. You ask him if he are fit to go." Anyway, she came. But by the time we came, we were stuck there for 5 days in the snow. Eventually, we came back, and she was holding my kurta, and I am chanting, "Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram Hare." Wo kya kar rahi hai? Deepak, Deepak ji, Deepak ji, Deepak ji. She's not chanting Lord's name. She's chanting my name. Kyunki she's holding my kurta. I said, "Yaar, Bhagwan ka naam le to dono ko fayda ho jayega." Kya? When we are in such tight situations where we are beyond our wits, have we trained enough that our mantra comes to our rescue?
Happens only if it is done regularly.
It is done not just regularly,
with
bhav, with devotion, with bhakti. With bhakti. Then it comes.
It can't be cheated.
You cannot cheat yourself. You cannot cheat the mantra also. It will come, provided you have done it with bhav, you have atmasat kiya usko. So that is this Siddha mantra. Namdev ji Maharaj used to call the Lord and get the jobs of all the devotees done. That is Siddha mantra. Vittala, 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 Vittala. Bhagwan aate the, kaam karke chale aate the. Siddha mantra does not mean liberation. Siddha mantra does not mean equal to realization. Siddha mantra is just one siddhi, some power by the grace which the great Lord has bestowed upon you, by which you are able to negotiate through life because you have done some tapasya. So whatever tapasya is there, some fruit will be there. You don't want it, but it will come. तो अभी मैंने एक दो एग्जाम्पल दे दिया, नामदेव जी का भी एग्जाम्पल दे दिया. तो यू ऑल्सो प्रिपेयर दैट वे. बट अवर गोल इज नॉट टू डू द मंत्रा सो दैट वी कैन सॉर्ट द वर्ल्ड आउट. नो, अवर गोल इज वैखरी मध्यमा पश्यंती परा. अवर गोल इज चैंटिंग द मंत्रा सो दैट वी कम टू अबाइड इन द सेल्फ एज द सेल्फ. सो दैट अवर माइंड डिसॉल्व्स, अवर इंडिविजुअलिटी डिसॉल्व्स थ्रू द कर्मा ऑफ चैंटिंग द मंत्रा. Action of chanting the mantra. O Arjuna, just as one should not forget the tested formula Siddha mantra in a difficult situation, one should not give up one's duty at any time. Now you determine what is your duty. Did Nisargadatta Maharaj give up his duty towards his family and wife and son when he locked himself up in a room for 2 years? Why you say no? Why you nodding?
No, because he didn't.
Why? How do you know? How do you say that?
Because he was still there. He did not leave them and go. Only he said.
No, but he is not there to communicate. He is not there to go for shopping. He is not there to clean the rooms. He is not able. He is only a dependent. The food has to be given under the door. If he eats, he eats. If he doesn't eat, it's going to waste. So is, and he was not there for consultation, he was not there for sharing their life for 2 years, nobody could talk to him. So what, he's living in the home, but he is actually a burden to the family.
But it's still there.
Yes.
It's still there at two levels. One is the physical level which we are talking about, available for action to interact. And the second thing is still mentally there, rather than being in the forest or in the mountains.
No, means he's not there for others. He might be in his own world, but like you are at your home, but you're still there for me. You don't need to be here for me. I know you're there, so you being there is enough for me.
So is Nisargadatta Maharaj performing his karma?
Yes.
Yeah, he is.
In what way?
Things are happening.
Explain.
If things are happening in his presence, it is getting done, or his physical is still there.
Your attention is on the family, because I started that way.
what is his swadharma when he is locked up in the room?
To chant, to be available.
What is his swadharma?
Sorry, going back one step up.
Reason why he came for? So that was his swadharma.
What is that?
I mean, what was the reason why he came for? So for him, that he needs to be chanting at that time.
Okay.
So going back one step, Krishna said, you surrender to me, I'll take care of you. So he surrendered to Lord. He knows the Lord gonna take care of it.
He didn't surrender to Lord. Nisargadatta Maharaj did not surrender to Lord. He said, I am that. Story over. God is because of me, I am not because of God.
So let's go one step further up.
He said, God is because of me. Now question, my question here, we are getting a little bit distracted here. Question is Nisargadatta Maharaj performing his swadharma?
Yes.
When Namdev's wife is continuously screaming, shouting, complaining to everyone and all, my husband is a good for nothing fellow, is Namdev performing his swadharma?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Is Gora Kumbhar, when he crushes his own child in the mud which is tramping upon to make it soft, is he doing his dharma?
Yes.
Performing his swadharma?
I don't know how to explain it to you,
yes.
But
from the wife's point of view, he's not.
From his point of view, he is. How?
Because that's what he's born for. That's what he wants to achieve.
To kill his own baby.
No,
that was a dharma.
No, he didn't kill it.
Correct.
So he was disidentified.
Again,
in all these arguments, I'm purposely putting these examples. Your attention is on what is happening.
Yep.
My question is swadharma. Is he performing swadharma? He was just remembering the Lord. He's totally disidentified with the body.
Yes.
He is totally disidentified with the world.
So
Gora Kumbhar did that. Namdev Maharaj was like that. Nisargadatta Maharaj was like that. And because before, at the relative level, worldly level, family level, they were performing their duties. They performed their dharma perfectly. Then, as you go from Vaikari to Madhyama, you migrate. Your assessment of swadharma changes.
Mm.
Now your swadharma is to chant the Lord's name to the exclusion of everything else. Your love for the Lord. Or in Nisargadatta Maharaj, that he went for one satsang and he was told, you are that. And he's thinking, I am that, how am I that? And he kept thinking that became his swadharma. And everything else became secondary. He's not wishing anyone bad. He sorted it all out, finances, everything. Now, I need these 2 years to dive deep. Just as we needed to go to the ashram to dive deep, to dive deep into the scriptures and reformat our mind. It is not possible for a normal person in the family environment. Because so many distractions are there. Nisargadatta Maharaj called. We have to be like Namdev. He chanted. Very rare ones are. Jnaneshwar Maharaj is a rare one. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa is a rare one. Gondolekar Maharaj is a rare one. But majority of them live for some time. For ekanta. Because, one thing, what you said, people will misunderstand. And secondly, we will get disturbed as we will not be able to focus deeply on what has grabbed our imagination, on what we are contemplating, what our dharma is. If we have decided my purpose of life is, see, your purpose of life as a husband or wife is as long as you are thinking you are the body. Not even the body, as long as you are thinking you are the husband and wife. But once you come to the body, your swadharma becomes yoga. When you come to pranas, your swadharma becomes pranayama.
when your attention comes to mind, it becomes dharana, dhyan, samadhi. And when it comes to liberation, then it becomes, if you go beyond it, see, because your dharma will be will express according to where your mind is. If your mind is at the body level, then accordingly the dharma will express. People may say whatever. We are not talking about what people say. We are talking about what you, your assessment about yourself is. What your assessment of yourself in your mind is.
That determines your direction.
See, we are living with mom. People are there around, but I never compromise. Who are? Everything else is okay. See, time ho gaya lagta hai. Quickly, we'll just finish quickly. Thoda sa ye. I'll read it and then we'll finish. One should not give up one's duty at any time. Now, 951st, quickly. Where are we? 951st, here. Ka na vasaisi udadhi maharogi devyaushadhi na visam vijetaya buddhi swakarma yetha magayaya chiga kapidhvaja swakarma chiya mahapuja तोशला ईशु तमरा तमरजा झाड़ा करूनी शुद्ध सत्वाचिया वाटा आनी आपुली उत्कंठा भवस्वर्ग काळकूटा ऐसे दावी जिहे वैराग्य येणे बोले मागा संसिद्धि रूप केले किं बहुना ते आपुले मेळवी खागे मग जिंतिलिया हे भोए पुरुष सर्वत्र जैसा होए का झाला ही जेला हे ते आता सांगो. He says, Nyaneshwar Maharaj says, as one who wishes to cross the sea should not forget to take the barge of, or one who is suffering from leprosy should not forget to take the medicine, so his intellect should not forget to follow his duty. This is our, whatever you, depends. At the body level you do, at the physical level, at the mind level, take the name of the Lord, or whichever way. When God is propitiated by worship in the form of performance of one's duty, he destroys the rajas and tamas qualities of the worshipper and leads him along the road of sattva quality and makes him feel heaven and earth like poison. Then the seeker attains the plane of non-attachment described under the term perfection before. In 95th OV of 18th chapter. Now, we'll take it next time. Now I shall state how the seeker behaves after attaining this plane of yoga and what position he secures thereby. So from 951st OV we'll look at it again in our next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः. हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः. हरिः ॐ. जस्ट सिट क्वाइटली फॉर अ मोमेंट.